security, watches them. This honor presents to the world a family tradition of tasty Caribbean style tea.
And coming up, we'll take a look at another thriving African American owned brand as we celebrate Black Business Month right here on the CIA. I'm Bill Davis, along with Esther Miller, on your home for 24/7 news and the Black Information Network. 100,000 CIA listeners were able to advance their careers or succeed in a new one. But it was in one step towards building a better future for all of us. To learn more about the 100,000 career positions, go to careerbuilder.com/CIS.
If you got it, we want to know about it.
To be a racially motivated attack. U.S. Attorney Darren LaMarca said this at a news conference.
These men sexually abused their victims.
Finally, oh my gosh, I'm here. Real Vista. Oh, you can't, I know. It's active, okay. Oh, one guy, his tattoos. Oh, man, it's fucking hot. Oh, nice sag from that guy, too. Fucking hot. Oh, it's so damn hot. Oh. Okay. Thank you. tattoos on that guy. Nice earrings, too. Oh, what type of guys? Oh, no. Oh, what type of guys? Okay. Oh, that lights up? Yeah, see. Kind of. Okay.
After they took part in a protest on the House floor in favor of stronger gun laws following a mass shooting that killed 6 people at a Christian school.
Every Tennessean needs to be very concerned that we are not in a democracy. And across the United States of America, there has been no House members who ever need to ever exercise their First Amendment rights in a peaceful protest. We are losing our democracy to white supremacy.
A third lawmaker narrowly escaped expulsion.
4 years later, family members in the community are still mourning after a Texas man started a shooting in an El Paso Walmart, claiming the lives of 23 victims and injuring 22 others.
A man is an individual filled with anger and filled with hate because of the color of their skin, because of their ethnicity, and they lost their lives on that day.
The FBI determined the shooting done by 21-year-old Patrick Wood Crucius was an act of domestic terrorism and a hate crime. After that, Crucius was charged with 90 federal charges and sentenced to 90 consecutive life sentences.
Aria Singh, a mother accused of disposing of and killing her black newborn baby in the Boynton Beach, Florida inlet, has been sentenced to 14 years in prison.
Well, I guarantee you, when you see an infant, newborn infant floating in the ocean, that somebody has discarded like a piece of trash.
Baby June was born on May 30th, 2018, and was tossed in the water just 2 days later on June 3rd.
California's Temecula Valley Unified School District is getting sued for its ban on critical race theory. Mark Rosenbaum with an organization called Public Counsel made the details of the lawsuit.
Public Counsel and the Washington Dallas are filing the first ever civil rights action in California, challenging the imposition of curriculum censorship.
Lawsuits filed on behalf of several parents, students, and teachers, as well as the Temecula Valley Educators Association. It says the ban on critical race theory is censoring teachers and infringes on students' fundamental right to education. The ban on Resolution 21 was approved by the district board in conservative majority last December.
August is Black Business Month, and Nicole Kane, owner of My Happy Flow, plant-based supplements to help alleviate the pains that come with a woman's cycle. Entrepreneurship is not as easy as some may think. In an interview with the Griot, Kane talks about her journey into e-commerce and describes it as, quote, a whole different ballgame. Despite the struggles, and in addition to her e-commerce business, she's managed to launch two successful media businesses. For more news impacting the Black community, listen to the Black Information Network or the iHeartRadio app, or log on to BINnews.com. I'm Amber Payton, along with Mike Stevens, on your home for 24/7 News, the Black Information Network.
Water table, Mr. Denver, and not the population one request to be found. Allensburg is now. on San Francisco's BIN 910. 7 months into her new job as Alameda County's new district attorney, Pamela Price is under fire. A group has launched an effort to have her recalled and removed from office. A civil rights attorney, Price ran on a platform of reform and transformation of the justice system, particularly for black and brown people. But critics accuse her of being soft on crime. Now one of her former prosecutors is arguing her silence about Price's decision to reduce the charges in one of the Bay Area's most infamous crime cases. She says Price's decision to remove the special circumstances in the case of David Nish, an accused serial killer, undid decades of investigative work. Alameda prosecutor Colleen McMahon is speaking out to NBC Bay Area, openly criticizing
that I know more about this case than anyone, probably even to this day.
Michaela Garrett calling the DA's decision unbelievable. Price saying she understands why they feel that way.
So I appreciate that they are still, you know, have been held hostage by the system because it's a case I've not really wrong after so many years. What my commitment to them was then and continues to be, and which I have fulfilled, is that we're going to prosecute this case as expeditiously as we can.
Nish remains locked up, charged for several times, but Garrett's family, who never recovered her body, wonders if they'll ever get true justice for the little girl who was killed 34 years ago when she was just 9 years old. And a Notre Dame University study says a program in Santa Clara County is preventing homelessness. A professor from the college said one-time financial assistance payment works. Santa Clara County program destination home, San Jose, can't give away money to families behind on rent or who are about to be homeless. The study says families that receive the financial assistance are likely to become homeless within a half year. The county program helped 14,000 people since it started in 2017. The chief program officer of Destination Home San Jose says with inflation, the amount is about $6,000 to $7,000 per family. The taxpayers will pay money in the long run. And one brewery wants to help another one reopen. Foxtail Fermentation Project in San Jose is making their own brew to sell in order to help Anchor Brewery in San Francisco, which recently closed its doors. Foxtail Brewery says their proceeds from the solidarity sale will go towards Anchor Brewery's reopening efforts. And that's a look at what's going on around the Bay Area. I'm Natasha Morgan from your home for 24/7 News in San Francisco, BIN 910. Thank you.
Black Information Network. It is 24/7 news.
The NAACP is working with the Department of Veteran Affairs and Virginia to improve the department's service for Black veterans or us.
The Bay Area's BIN 910 on the iHeartRadio app.
Rebounds and 2.1 assists across 29 games last season, with the
Westchester Knicks of the G League. He has started 22 of the 51 holes since he has played for Westchester and that's 9 o'clock.
Writers and actors' strike could be holding up their slate of new movies. Comedian Diane Sand